In this problem, preparation of cash flow statement, actually they have asked you to prepare only cash flows from operating activities, where I'm going to prepare the entire cash flow statement. And we have started also the continuation of that only we are going to discuss in the session. Till this one we have completed, that is from net profit, you have added your transfer to general reserve, and then your depreciation and found out operating profit before working capital changes. With that increase in current liability, anything, and decrease in current asset, anything we have to add. And whereas we have to subtract, increase in current assets, anything if there, you have to subtract that one. Let us find out whether any increase in current asset. Stock and debtors both have increased. Stock for 10,000 and debtors 30,000, it has got increased. Prepaid expenses, it is a decrease, already we have done. Cash, it will not be taken, only at the end it will be taken. So stock and debtors are 10,000, 30,000 we have to mention. Stock and then debtors. So the amount is 10,000 and 30,000. The difference of that, 10,000 and 30,000. And then you will find out the amount. Before that, any decrease in current liability, you have to check, because that also we have to enter. If it is there, we can write, or else you can skip. Just we can go. Creditors, bills payable, these two are the current liabilities. Other than that, nothing is current liability. So creditors increase, bills payable is also increased. Already we have mentioned those two items. So decrease in current liability, nothing will appear. So we can skip. Either you can write it and put nil, or you can skip also. Okay. Now these two items you have to subtract from 29,000. Either you can have here also, if you're getting confused, no, you can have here 29,000. Then 10,000 plus 30,000, 40,000 you can put and you can subtract, or else from 29,000 you subtract 29,000 minus 10,000 minus 30,000 you subtract, and final amount you just enter over here. Okay, so find out how much you are getting. 29 minus 10 minus 30. I think it's 11,000. Just find out. 11,000 in negative you are getting, because these all minus. Either you can show in bracket now itself also. Subtract items you can show now itself in bracket also. It's your wish, okay? You can also show in bracket negative, so that you will not get confused. Edala minus panmo the bracket la kuda you can neenga vandu kaanchikittu adukapra final answer you can enter here. Okay. So I think you are getting 11,000 here. Okay, this amount is known as cash used in operating activities. Cash used in operating activities, this amount. Okay, if you get in negative, no, it is cash used. Otherwise, cash from. Okay. Mentioned in brackets, because you might forget and you will add, so better to mention in brackets. Okay, next comes your investing activities. Investing activities. So what all the sale and purchase you just find out. Okay, purchase of machinery, sale of machinery or furniture, any kind of fixed asset. Similarly, investment purchase, and then any long-term loans borrowed or repaid, that will come here. So find out here, plant and machinery, it has been purchased. So purchase of machinery, plant and machinery, you have to show 36,000 within brackets. Similarly, investments, purchase of investments, 50,000, you have to show within brackets. Other than that, anything else, you just check it out. Okay, just check it out and find out anything. Long term liabilities is not here. You don't have any loan here. Okay, so no bank loan is given. So just you can skip. So plant and machinery 36,000 and investment 50,000 I have to show now. So purchase of plant and machinery and purchase of investments. So this amount is 36,000 and this amount is purchase of investment is 50,000. 50,000 you can mention here. Okay, now these two amounts, since it is a purchase, it is an outflow of cash, so I have to mention in brackets, because in order to calculate, suppose sale is there, no, that will be an inflow, it is a positive thing. Okay, that I must show in positive, but purchase I can show it in negative since it is an outflow. Now any other sale or purchase further, anything you have to just go through, nothing is there. Okay, so we can close this. So actually our outflow will be 86,000. All these things you know, minus 36, minus 50, we have to plus and show it in negative sign. So all these things you might know. So this is known as cash used in investing activities. Just see whether any item I'm skipping out, okay? Because final answer, we should get right answer. So all those things also we have to check. Next is your financing activities. Okay. So here we will bring all your issue of share capital, issue of debentures, anything. Issue of debentures, nothing, because 1 lakh, 1 lakh, both get tallied. Okay. So both are same. So no issue or redemption. But share capital, it is an issue. 1 lakh they have issued. Okay. So issue of share capital we have to show. So some in question and some problems, proceeds from issue. Proceeds na income. They are getting some revenue, no? That is known as proceeds. So you can show issue of share capital, proceeds from issue of share capital, whatever might be. You are getting 1 lakh amount. This is a source for the company. Only if you redeem, no, then that is known as redemption. Then that is known as outflow. Now this is inflow. So you can show just like that 1 lakh. Okay. So no other amount will come. Everything has been included here. So we can go further. So this 1 lakh amount is, it is a positive thing. So 1 lakh I'm mentioning here. So this amount is known as cash from investing activities. Cash from investing activities. Okay. And moving to the other one. So cash from financing activities. Sorry. So this amount is known as cash from financing activities. So we have made from operating activities, and then finance investing activities, and the last one is financing activities. So these are the our final answers, where you have to add all these things and find out how much net cash and cash equivalent you are getting. Okay, so minus 11,000, minus 86,000, if you do minus 97,000, we will get minus 97,000. With which 1 lakh you have to add. 1 lakh if you add means you will get how much? 3,000 you will get. So you just check it out whether I'm doing right. Okay, now this amount is known as net cash and cash equivalents. Net cash and cash equivalents. With this opening balance, we have to add. Opening balance is 15,000 cash. Only cash is given here. If bank is also there, cash and bank both you have to add. But here only cash we have. So that cash we have to add it here. Okay. Plus opening balance of cash. This amount will be 15,000, which I got from our question. From our question, it is there 15,000. Now, if you add these together, you will get an amount of 18,000. Now, this amount is known as closing cash balance. Suppose bank is also there, bank balance, closing cash and bank balance, or else you can write cash and cash equivalents at the end of the year. Now this answer, 18,000, should match with our question, closing cash balance. Okay, if you see here also 18,000, that same 18,000 only we are also getting here, closing as closing cash balance. So like this only you have to prepare your cash flow statement as per accounting standard 3. Okay, so this is the method how you have to prepare. So if you have certain items, you just write, or else you can even skip, or you can even put and you can mention as nil. And like this only you have to find out your closing cash balance. And if your answer is with this, it is both same, then your answer is right. So this is the way to prepare cash flow statement as per accounting standard 3.